Boneyard Commandos. It was one of those really weird anthropomorphic type toy lines that came out from Playmates Toys in 1989. And you know what? It's so weird that it totally deserves a comeback. Okay, alright, okay, I'm not gonna go through this entire video and pretend like we don't already know that there is a Barnyard Commandos comeback in the works right now from the folks over at Megalopolis Toys. But let's go ahead and focus on that original toy line for a little bit, just so you can see why I think this awesome weirdo toy line from the late 80s is perfect for an action figure comeback right now. So Barnyard Commandos was created for American Greetings by James Grohman. And if that name sounds familiar to you, well, that's because he's the genius behind the Madballs. That's right, James Grohman makes some amazing art. Just recently, he did some incredible Artist Alley figures for DC Direct. I mean, look at that Two-Face. It is absolutely one of my favorite designs to come out of the Artist Alley series. And of course, I'm a huge fan of the Madballs, so yes, I am a fan of James Grohman. And Barnyard Commandos, believe it or not, was one of the very first things that James worked on right out of art school. So this is a property that is near and dear to James Grohman, and it is a weird one, but it totally screams 90s. Even though it was 89 when it first came out. So Playmates Toys was the company that produced the action figure line, and of course, 89 was right there at the very beginning of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles craze, so it makes perfect sense that we started to see a lot of toy lines that sort of had that similar humor, had the anthropomorphic kind of designs. Yeah, Barnyard Commandos fits right in with that. It even got a cartoon series, and while all of that was really fun, it unfortunately didn't last very long. We really only got a very short amount of action figures that were produced, but what was released was quite a bit of fun. Barnyard Commandos! There we go, our action figures from Playmates Toys. Obviously, when we're taking a look at the card back here, everything about it screams Playmates from that era. You can totally get that same kind of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles vibe off of the packaging here, and to me, that's pretty awesome. Every one of these card backs has a fun little comic strip on the back, as well as a little bio card for each of the characters right there at the bottom. And just to kind of give you guys an idea of what's going on here, we have two factions within Barnyard Commandos. We have the Porks, which is an acronym for Platoon of Rebel Killer Swine. Yep. So that's our group of pigs. And then we've got the Rams, which is the Rebel Army of Militant Sheep. Yeah, they're the sheep. So we have pigs versus sheep. I mean, that's basically as simple as I can make this entire thing. But they're animals that have all this crazy military gear that clips onto them. The toys themselves are very interesting because they're hollow, they're soft, they kind of have what a lot of people consider to be a dog toy type quality. There's no articulation to speak of whatsoever, and they each come with these crazy militaristic type weapons that just clips onto the characters. It's kind of weird, but at the same time, I don't know, man, I totally dig them. Here, I've got General Ham Fat Lardo right here. Let me just kind of read this bio for you guys. First of all, it says his code phrase is Utpe the Arms Ray into Orbit A. I mean, get it, they're pigs, so their code is Pig Latin. Good stuff. So it says, known to his platoon as Top Pig, General Lardo is supremely confident of his own expertise. This may be due to his secret belief that he is the reincarnation of many famous generals. His battle record contradicts his beliefs, but no one will ever tell him because of his fierce and terrible temper. It's so dumb. So dumb, but that's why I love it. I don't know. I get a real big kick out of these weird oddball toy lines like this. And these were so common back in the day. We don't see a lot of really like original weird stuff like this anymore. And that is why I think something like this totally deserves a redo. Because even though this was super niche, it didn't have a lot of toys and it probably didn't sell very well back in the day. Hey, there's people out there like me that love collecting this weird kind of stuff. So bring them on. So as I said, we already know that Megalopolis is releasing a brand new line, and the pre-orders are beginning very, very soon. We've seen some of the early prototypes. We know that this time around, they are full-on action figures, chock full of articulation, and these are going to be a lot of fun. And even more, James Grohman himself is directly involved with the new toy line. It's sort of like he's getting a second chance to produce action figures off of one of his very first ideas. How cool is that? So do we need new Barnyard Commandos toys? I like weird stuff. So you're damn right we do. I would stay tuned to Megalopolis if I were you guys.